Good evening. I'd like to call the regular monthly meeting to order. Would everyone please rise for the prayer and the Pledge of Allegiance?
Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you this evening asking for your guidance as we try to make decisions that are in the best interest of all the children of St. Bernard Parish. Help us to continue to work in a fashion that moves our school district forward. And as we face the challenges before us, help us to stand together in our efforts to be fair and transparent in our decisions. Again, we ask that you be with our students and school board family as the holiday approaches. Many will be traveling, and we ask that you watch over them and return all of them to us safely after the short break. These things we ask in your name.
Amen. Amen.
Mr. Warren, would you lead us in the pledge, please?
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please, Ms. Foche.
Mrs. Acevedo.
Here.
Mr. Campbell.
Here.
Dr. Kraft.
Here.
Mr. Egan is not with us. Mr. Gaines.
Here.
Mr. England.
Here.
Mrs. Dysart.
Here.
Mrs. LeMoyne.
Here.
Dr. Lewis is not here. Mr. Long.
Here.
And Mr. Warren.
Here.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Foche. Before we go on to the first item on the agenda, Mr. England had a point of privilege.
Yes, thank you, Ms. Dysart. This past weekend was a beautiful day, and all of a sudden all our bands, our students marched in the parades, and I just want to say they did a fantastic job. I really want to thank, you know, all the teachers and the support of the parents. That's mm-hmm. the main thing, because I saw a lot of parents, you know, marching behind the bands and drill squads. So they really did a fine job, and I just want to give that a little vote of thanks. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. England. Yes, each and every one of the schools look great on the parade route. And as you mentioned, so many parents and the teachers were out there, and it was a beautiful day for the whole parish, and they did great. Thank you. Okay, first item on the agenda is the public hearing on new school attendance zones for Araby, Chalmette, Lacoste, Miro, and Davies Elementary Schools. Ms. Foche?
Okay, as everyone has known and as we discussed at prior meetings, we are building or in the process of building a new elementary school, the Arlene Merrill Elementary. Due to the overcrowding of the schools within the district from the Orleans Parish line through the Davies Elementary District, we have over 900 students at Lacoste. We have over about 870 at Davies and well over 700 at each of the Chalmette Elementary and Araby Elementary, and growing in those particular areas. So the Merrill Foundation donated the land to us, and we were able to put together the funds from the sources that we've had in funding since the hurricane, so that the new school was built with dollars, which are a combination of FEMA dollars and CDBG funds and insurance proceeds. So we're thankful that we were able to do that without any local funds to build the new school. And of course, we've been, over the last few months, seeing the progress of the building of the new Merrill Elementary School. It's going to be a fantastic facility with all of the programs that we have throughout the other elementary schools in the district. The curriculum is standard throughout the elementary schools, the clubs, the activities. So it's going to be just a wonderful experience. Teachers from the current schools will be moving to the new elementary along with the students that they teach. So I think it's just going to be, hopefully, the excitement of opening up a new school. You know, there's always a little bit pain within the process of families having to move into a new facility and being redistricted. When we looked at the lines and trying to keep the lines fairly straight with the neighborhood somewhat intact and looking at natural boundaries and balance off the numbers at the schools. When we discussed this last week at the board meeting, and then we sent out the letters to all of the parents outlining outlining what the lines would be with a map enclosed, and informing them that we would have this public hearing before y'all would consider the actual vote on these particular lines to see what that public input would be. We have over 4,000 elementary school students. This would be a movement of a few hundred. We would probably move about 150 students from the Davies, about 200 students from Lacoste School, and then about 100 from each of Araby Elementary and Chalmette Elementary Schools, and the staff would move with it. Now, while we have that in place, we are, as we redistrict each time we do this, because we've been through this process many times, both before Hurricane Katrina and then subsequent to Hurricane Katrina, every time we've opened a new school, we've had to redraw the lines. And just as we've done that, we look at the students who are going to be in their exit year, which from the elementary perspective would be going into the fifth grade, and give parents the option of leaving their children in their current school in the fifth grade if they provide the transportation, or moving them to the new district school. There have been questions about uniforms, and just as we've done in the past, we've allowed all of the pants, skirts, shorts, and the white shirts are consistent throughout all of our schools. The shirts that designate the schools, they're able to wear, if they still fit the children the next year, to wear those uniforms to the new school until they outgrow them, and then purchase new uniforms for that. So we've been through that particular process basically in the same way every time we've opened. Since the storm, I think we had the elementary students at Chalmette High, then we moved them. We opened Andrew Jackson as an elementary. And from that point, then we opened Davies and we opened Smith. And then we opened the new Goche and the new Lacoste. So each time we've opened the new schools, we've had to go through a similar process in the redistricting of our lines. So with that, Ms. Dyser.
Can you explain the process, how you looked at the map?
Well, we sat down with the map. We sat down with the numbers of students that we had. We looked at the particular neighborhoods. We tried to keep neighborhoods together. We tried to balance the numbers. We spent many, many hours and days. Ms. Harleton, who's our elementary supervisor, Ms. Lumetta, who does the accountability plan, has all the information and data on our students, myself, Ms. Larson, and a group of people, as we sat down and looked at what we felt the best configuration would be for a presentation to you as a school board.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Vochang. And before we begin the public hearing, for those of you who may have come in after the meeting started and we hadn't been able to discuss with you, if you would like to speak, if you would fill out a card and your address and the reason for speaking, of course, we're on item number 4, it would be the public hearing. So if you haven't had an opportunity to do so, please fill out a card if you'd like to speak and hand it to Ms. Shelby Benazat.
Interesting example.
Thank you. And we do have quite a few people who would like to speak. And according to our board policy, we would ask if you would try to keep it to about 3 minutes so everyone can be heard. And, we'd appreciate it, okay? All right. First of all, thank you. Okay, first, we have Chantel Dakin. And if I mispronounce your name, I apologize. Good evening.
How are y'all?
Hi.
You bear with me. I'm not a public speaker, but I lived on Rosetta my whole life, and I went to Miro Elementary, and After y'all closed down Miro, I was at Lacoste for the remainder of my elementary school. And it's always been, that street has always been in Lacoste District. And now that I have a daughter, she's in pre-K, and it was very, very difficult for me and her to adjust with me being a stay-at-home mother, and for me to let her go to a school in the first place, it was a process. And we've gotten very comfortable with Lacoste, and she's very comfortable. She loves her school, and I drop her off every morning. I pick her up every afternoon, and it takes me 5 minutes or less. And with my side of Rosetta being in the new school district, it'll take me 10, maybe 15, maybe 20 minutes, depending on traffic, to bring her in to pick her up in the afternoons. And there's many reasons why we love Lacoste. It's a good school, good people, and I like that it's ducked off in a neighborhood. It's not on a highway. And I just don't understand how one side of my street is in the district and my side isn't. And that's mostly my concern.
Okay, thank you.
Thank
you. We appreciate your comments, and we'll take them into consideration. Okay, next. We have Jamie Dorr. Good evening.
I have a daughter who attends, she's in second grade, she attends Chalmette Elementary. And she is a student that has special needs. And the switch around, the redistricting, would cause us a lot of, her mostly, a lot of undue stress, because not only would she have to change schools, change environments, everything like that, but her daycare, she attends Milestones. And this bus actually picks her up, drops her off right there. She's been attending that facility since she was 18 months old. They're familiar with her conditions. And not only would she have to change schools, but I wouldn't be able to drop her off and get to work on time. Or have the bus to drop her off, and someone in my family, my father, usually goes and picks her up. It would completely switch around her schedule, and it would take her out of an environment that both her elementary school and her daycare are familiar with her needs, and she's comfortable with them, and it's just something that would cause a lot of undue stress, just, you know, and it just wouldn't work out for us at all. So, thank you.
Thank you. Okay, next we have Sarah Kevorkian.
Hi, good evening. So my kids go to Lacoste, and they'll stay going to Lacoste, but my problem is they go to stay and play daycare.
They what?
They go to stay and play daycare, which because of the rezoning is no longer in Lacoste. And they are actually, their address is on Judge Perez. It's just the south side of Judge Perez, though. So technically, I believe it says that the south side would be a part of the new Miro. Whereas if you were on the north side, it would be a part of the Lacoste district. So with the rezoning the way it is we wouldn't have the daycare to send our kids to for the before and after, for them to be able to be picked up and dropped off from school to the daycare. And to the best of my knowledge, there's no other daycares in Lacoste school zone that offer before and after care. So, and we would be one of like 10 families that are affected, about 20 kids in total. If you just accept the south side of Judge Perez, we would be okay. So that's all I have. Thank you.
Okay. Next we have Felicia Reagan.
Hello. I am a St. Bernard resident. I graduated from Andrew Jackson in 98, went to Lacoste also. I moved back 4 years ago to be in the Lacoste district so my kids can go there. With this new zone, I'm the last street. I'm the Lambert. Golden's in the street behind me. I would like for my child, who's going to go to pre-K, to go to Lacoste. I will provide transportation to and from school, so I just wanted to see if y'all would consider that option. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Next, we have Christina DeLon.
I'm actually new to the Chalmette area, so I have a lot of questions. I came from an A-plus school, a magnet school in the West Bank, and my move to Chalmette was quite difficult. I watched the report cards for 3 years, the state report cards. So what I'd like from you guys is, with the students transitioning, can you tell me what the report card would look like? Say the fourth and fifth grade LEAP scores? Because that would monitor my decision as to where my kids would go to school. Like these guys, before and after care is a huge issue for me. I have one kid going to middle school, so it's a moot point, but I have one kid who's staying in Lacoste. I can't bring him to and from school. Not gonna happen. I work in the CBD. I have a great bus driver, love her, latchkey kids. I'm just stuck. Can we consider before and after care? I mean, are there any teachers who want extra compensation? Like daycare, my kids are tall, the tables are here, I checked them out, they smell like poopies. I'm just asking, I don't know. I'm new to the district. The school I came from before had it, and teachers provided it. They sat in the cafeteria, and then they played in the playground. I mean, I used to teach at Archbishop Hannon, and any additional comp I could get, I was on it. So if maybe we can put that on the next agenda. Overcrowding. Y'all mentioned overcrowding, the whole reason for the Muro Elementary. Great. I know that that does change the progression of students, but what happens next? I did visit middle school before I moved here, and I know that was a little presumptuous, but the counselor mentioned that they too are overcrowding. Is it that many kids going to private school when they move to middle school, or what is that transition? I mean, is there a plan for a middle school, or are we going to suffer with overcrowding for me next year and the year after? I don't know. So that's another question. So if maybe y'all can provide some numbers on that, that would be helpful to me. Maybe everybody else. With regard to the waiver, again, I just moved here, so my kid's first year at Lacoste, love it. Ms. Powers, fourth grade, awesome teacher, just saying. They're involved in everything, academic games, not everything, but a lot. The waiver I would love to request, but like I said, I cannot drop my kids off and pick them up every day. It's not possible. It's just, I have to work. So super important is the either before care, after care option, or if there's, I don't know, some other option. If Muro's numbers look as pretty as Lacoste numbers, then I don't really care anymore about before and after care, because I don't mind them going to a different school. But I monitor those reports like you don't want to know. You're going to probably send me to a psychiatrist. And you mentioned that teachers were moving from the schools, and I was wondering how many teachers from Lacoste are going to Muro and which grades. I think that will be helpful in giving the parents some security and comfort. And where are the new teachers coming from? And I don't know how the source of funding for teachers comes to Chalmette. Is this a taxpayer issue? Do y'all have money for that? Because obviously there's new teachers and new administrators with a new school. I know the school was built with funding that was already in the system, but what happens next? So that's it.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, next we have Karen Harder. And just to let the public know, I'm sorry, that the public hearing is for us to take the input from the public, you know, and consider it. That's why no one's really saying anything. We're listening. Okay, thank you. Karen Harder.
I'm sorry, I've never been on the spot like this, so I'm probably going to stutter and get a little nervous.
It's okay, it's all right.
My backyard is the cutoff, so so y'all just missed us. I moved down here from Biloxi. I had a rough time before I moved here. But I've been here for about 6 years. I lived in the same home. Like I said, my backyard's the cutoff. My son goes to La Coste, and I would like for him to stay at La Coste because I see that he's doing good. He makes straight A's. This whole month has been his month. He had a terrific kid. He made Duke this year, so Friday he'll be in the parade. And what else was it? Made straight A's, terrific kid, and a Duke. Okay, so I'm sorry. I'm very nervous right now.
That's all right. Take your time.
But I would like for him to stay at the school because I see that he does really good, and I don't want to have to move, you know, in order for him to stay in the school district. I don't want to have to start over again because we basically just started over 6 years ago. I don't want to go in my past because it'll be a long story. But I love it here. I'm from Biloxi. It's big, you know, but I love it here. It's small. Everything's close by. And my children love it. And my youngest son, he's 4, he'll start school in August, and he always says he wants to be a bulldog like his bubba. But I don't really have too many concerns besides, you know, my son hears us talking or hears other people talking, and he don't want to start over either. But like I said, my backyard's the cutoff. If there was any way y'all could just move that street over one more, that would be perfect. I really love La Coste, and I love the feeling of it. You know, when I go in, I'm always welcomed, and the teachers are great, and my son's doing wonderful. I just don't want anything to affect him, you know. And I know everybody has to get used to a change at some point in time, but like I said, we just started over. I don't want to have to start over again. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. You did good. Okay, that was Karen. Next, we have Jeff Sutherland.
Hello, everybody. How are y'all tonight?
Good.
All right. First off, thank you all for letting me address the board. And I'm speaking from a personal St. Bernardian level, just to let y'all know. While I think the new elementary school lines are drawing fairly well, I do have one or two concerns about it. First, there is one school that the population has, according to the lines that I see, a lower socioeconomic level. But that's not a total distress to me, because I know St. Bernard Parish public schools are great, and I know they will do well. So I'm not overly concerned about that. However, the main reason why I am here is because I'm a resident of Trist District. While I do not have any kids, I know that sometimes things don't change in this parish. So 10 or 11 years from now, I will be facing this issue possibly. They have 4 feeder schools going into Trist Middle School. The population of Trist, I want to say, is around 680 students. That's a lot of students for a middle school campus, a true middle school campus. Andrew Jackson and St. Bernard Middle were built as high school campuses. They have a little bit more room. So I'm a little bit concerned about that, because when you're bringing 4 different groups of kids into one middle school, that's a lot of work on the teachers, a lot of work on the administration of that school, and scary for the parents as well. So I'm just a little bit hesitant about that, because they're going to be dealing with groups they've never dealt with before. You have different groups of kids interacting with each other, and not so much similar feelings. So their sixth grade year is going to be, which is already a stressful year to begin with, their sixth grade year is going to be very stressful, and the fact that they're going with 3 different groups of kids. So I'm kind of a little bit scared about that. So my request to you as school board members is to look at an equitable distribution of students for the middle school level. Or there's also other options, possibly building Trist to be a bigger school. I don't know if we have any FEMA funds left. I know that's always been said before, but possibly building Trist into a bigger school, or equitable redistribution of students. I think that will help to continue that level of success for all students in St. Bernard Parish. And by the way, if y'all, like, I don't know how committees work here or if y'all have committees, but I'd be willing to help out if y'all ever do have a committee on student lines being drawn. Thank you for your time and attention. Y'all have a good one.
Thank you. Okay. Next, we have Timothy Miller. Hi.
How y'all doing? My question was, how do y'all put, like the lady said, how does one half of a street get to go to one school and the other half of the street got to be going to another school? Like, I live on Shalona, and the school ain't but two blocks away from my house, and I got the other half going to La Costa, and I got the other half going to the new school. I mean, I'd like, for two blocks away, I'd like my child to stay going to that school when it's right there by my house. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Next, we have Jess Wood Jr.
How y'all doing?
Hi.
I'm simply just the same as breath as him. I'm on Volpe, one street over. I cross the highway, I go to La Costa, I come, you know, stay here, go to Mural. How did y'all draw, who drew this? How did y'all draw this? I mean, straight across the highway is La Costa. This way, Davies is closer to Mural. In fact, Chalmette's even closer to Mural. So why am I going, wait, you know, the second furthest school away? That's my main concern. And on top of it, yeah, we love La Costa. My son, you know, academic games. So that's mainly it. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff. Okay, next we have Kayla Tortorich.
Hello, thank you for hearing me. And I want to tell everybody I did public speaking my entire life, and I'm still nervous as can be, so that makes you feel better. And I wish I would wear makeup. So I'm kind of the same as a lot of these other people. I moved here. I grew up in public school my entire life, so this is completely new to me. We had one school in my little bitty town of Franklinton, Louisiana, and everybody went to Franklinton. It was Franklinton primary, elementary, junior high, high school. That's it. And my husband went to Catholic school, so I know this was his hardest decision, was what kind of school are our kids going to go to? And it was like, do we want to have one child and send them to a private school, or as many children as I want to have? And as y'all seen, I had those three adorable children I just kicked out of here. So, yeah, so, and we love, I actually moved here. One of my best friends is Felicia, the person I'm sitting next to, and some of our other relatives, they go to La Costa, and that's the reason why we bought the house that we did, was because we're in La Costa School District. And I'm a little concerned of moving to the new school, and I'm sure it's going to be a wonderful school, but it doesn't have the, you know, the test scores, everything that the other schools do. And I'm actually considering moving now, not outside of Chalmette, because I'm a Chalmatian now, all the way. But tomorrow, I scheduled three houses. One is in La Costa. Actually, two of them are still in La Costa District, and another one is in Joe Davies. And I don't want to have to move. I financially really can't afford to move, but I'd like to stay in the school. And I'm on to Lambert, which is right next to Golden. So if I have to, I'll put a mailbox in the back of my yard if I need to. So I'll drive anywhere where there's the lowest amount of people. I'll drive all the way down to, I am not an original Chalmatian, so please tell me, Goche, is that the name of the school? I'll go wherever. I just want to be in a school that I know my son will succeed and do well, and that's all I want for him. So, thank you.
Thank you, Kayla. Okay. This is all the cards that have been given to us thus far. Is there anyone in the audience who might have came in late and didn't have an opportunity to fill one out? If you would like to speak at this time, please do so. And we'll give you a second just to fill it out. And by the way, all of you did an excellent job of presenting yourselves. I think each and every one of us still get nervous too. We do. Good evening. Okay, we have glasses. Yeah. Latrice Harris.
Yes, good evening. My son go to Joe Davies. It's been his first school ever, so for him it's pretty, he want to be there. So my thing, I just want to know if the parents have an option to where the kid could be grandfathered in if they already been there, pretty much, because he don't want to go. So if grandfathering could be an option, I would love that, because we love babies too, so thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Is there anyone else that would like to speak at this time who has not had a chance? Okay. Thank you, all of you, for coming tonight, and thank you very much for your input. We appreciate it, and again, we will take all of your concerns in consideration. At this time, I now close the public hearing on the new school attendance zones, and we will address the motion to approve the new school attendance zones for Araby, Chalmette, Lacoste, Miro, and Davies Elementary Schools. There was no recommendation from the committee, so at this time, I'll open the floor up for discussion. Oh, I'm so sorry. Thank you. I'd like to close the public hearing at this time and address the next item, which is the motion to approve the new school attendance zones for Araby, Chalmette, Lacoste, Miro, and Davies Elementary Schools. There was no recommendation from the committee. Discussion at this time, board members. Mr. Long?
Well, I know Ms. Foce and her administration has put a lot of work and a lot of effort into drawing these lines, and quite a few of these people brought up some pretty good concerns. I'm planning on voting to approve the recommendation of the administration, although I would like Ms. Voce to maybe address one or two of these concerns, like this gentleman who talked about Tris School. I think we may have some plans for our Tris School, and maybe my other concern would probably, one of the most pressing things would be the special needs child. That's, I think that may be something you may want to comment on, so if you don't mind.
Sure. If we have children with special needs, then we will talk with you individually about the child and in terms of just exactly what those are. We've had some discussion. I'm aware of your situation, and we will have a private discussion about your child, you know, and address those particular concerns. As far as the Trist issue or the middle school issue, as the gentleman said, we have three middle schools, St. Bernard Middle and Andrew Jackson Middle, were formerly high school campuses with significant amounts of room. Andrew Jackson and Trist have basically the same population, same numbers of students in each of those two schools. At Trist, we are building another wing onto Trist. Yeah, I see you doing that. that will be going out shortly, because we do recognize that we need a little bit more space in the school. We don't see it increasing in numbers, because as you look at the demographics of the students that are coming up, we have plenty of room, you know, in the middle schools. In fact, lots of empty classrooms. So we don't have an issue with space at the middle schools. The elementary situation that we discussed, we tried very hard to keep the ratios at the elementary level at close to 20-1. Even though in the fourth and fifth grade, by law, we're allowed to go up to 33 children in a class. We don't think that's a good educational environment, and we try to keep as close to 20 to 1 as possible. We're not currently able to do that because of the space limitations. We go over those numbers at Davies significantly. We go over those numbers in some classes at Lacoste. So what we are trying to do in freeing up some of that space, we have no classrooms available at Lacoste, no classrooms available at Davies currently. There is nothing that we can do to create additional space there. And when we look at central facilities or central functions such as feeding children, play areas, things that we're looking at, we can't. It's having over 900 children on a campus, on an elementary pre-K to 5 campus, is really not a good thing to do. And Davies is getting those high numbers as well. The classrooms at Davies, we're looking at K to 3, we're going as high as 25, 26 in a class. So we're hoping to bring those down to the 20 to 1 ratios. The same thing at Lacoste and all of our schools, because to build that foundation for our students, it's extremely important that they get the individual attention of the teachers. And as those numbers rise, it's very, very difficult to do. You know, I've made notes on everyone who has spoken today. I've talked with other parents on the phone that they've called about different situations that we've been able to resolve. I know the daycare issue. There is daycare in the Lacoste district. Now, I don't know what the, because we've talked to the daycare centers in terms of, do they offer before and after care, where they're located, transportation-wise, what they do. So we do provide bus transportation to the daycare within the zones of the schools that they reside. Prior to the storm, we did not. You know, the daycares provided their own transportation. But as we've climbed back from the storm, we've been trying to assist in that endeavor. We do have Araby Elementary School that we offer an extended day program, which is both before and after care at Araby for any parent who works and needs that at the Araby site. In the New Merrow district, there are at least 5 or 6 daycares that take before and after school children, because we have checked that out with them. So there are plenty daycare available in that New Merrow district, and those children would be transported by bus if they're dropped off at the daycare in the morning and then picked up later in the evening if the parents are working. That daycare is available for the students. So as a school district, we offer it at Araby Elementary School and allow parents to sign up there and send their children there. And if in the New Merrow district, there are many, many daycares that offer that. And as I said, in the Lacoste area, there is at least one that I know of and that we are familiar with. I know that when you talk about one side of the street and the other side of the street, you know, Judge Perez is a natural boundary, just like St. Bernard Highway, just like Parish Road. So you could be on one side of Parish Road and go one place, the other side. Same thing happens with Judge Perez and possibly St. Bernard Highway. I know it's very, very difficult. When we sit down and try to balance off numbers in neighborhoods to make sure that all children have the same services available, these are not easy things to do, and in no way does anyone around this particular table would ever, you know, hurt a child or a family intentionally. We provide the same curriculum, the same services, the same gifted program, the same academic games, the same special needs programs and such at all of our schools. And we do that, you know, our supervisors of the elementary curriculum, our supervisor of special education, our supervisor of all the different areas make sure that the programs that we offer are consistent among all of our elementary schools. So we try to address each and every one of those. If anyone has any extenuating individual circumstances, you know, I'll be happy to talk with those parents individually.
Thank you, Ms. Voce. I think you've addressed most of the concerns that I heard from the people here tonight. Thank you.
Okay. Anyone else at this time? Okay. I would just like to say that it's good that so many of you love the schools that your children are in at this presently. I mean, it's great. We're very blessed in St. Bernard Parish to have a great faculty and staff members that do care about individual needs at every school. So it's great to hear all the positives about the schools that your child is in. And just to let each and every one of you know that this decision is difficult. I don't think any of us are taking the decision lightly. As Ms. Voce stated, you know, it was very difficult as far as, you know, going through the map, you know, the entire elementary school districts and looking at the numbers and, you know, trying to even out, you know, the schools. We're very, very blessed that we have a brand new school. Miro Elementary is just incredibly beautiful. We're going to have a great staff there also. And again, as Ms. Voce said, you know, the programs will all be the same at all of the schools. And we do try to remain consistent, you know, in each of the schools and provide the same services to each of those schools. The lines, are difficult. No matter where the line is, someone's going to be on this side or that side. It's hard for change for any of us. And, Ms. Voce mentioned the amount of students and the teachers in each of the classes. Be assured that, you know, all of the schools will be smaller with student-teacher ratios, which is a great thing that we're able to even have an additional school to provide smaller classes for the students' needs. And, we're very blessed in St. Bernard Parish that we have a solution to accommodate our ever-changing population and our growing, which is a great thing, but in growth, like anything else, it's very difficult. And, you know, for growing pains and change, and none of us like change, and believe me, none of us here do. Years ago, I personally was involved in my son, who was in fourth grade, and we were very, very close to Lacoste Elementary, and that's where he went till fourth grade. And then in fifth grade, we had to redistrict because, you know, the population changed. And at that time, we didn't even give the grandfathering of a child to stay at their school if they're in fourth grade going into fifth. So he had to move from Lacoste to Joe Davies, and that was a brand new school at the time. And it was a beautiful facility, and of course, I resisted too. I didn't want him to go to a new school because he had already, you know, been pre-K to fourth grade at Lacoste. And, you know, some of his friends were moving, some of his friends weren't. And it was difficult on me because I had really good friends at Lacoste too that weren't moving. And it was, more importantly, difficult for him, but he adjusted, I think, better than I did. Mm-hmm. And he wound up loving Joe Davies. You know, and then, of course, middle school was the next year and had to change again. So please know that, you know, this decision is a difficult one for all of us. And, we just feel for those students that do have to change. But, again, just know that, you know, that no matter what school your child will be going to next year, it will be an excellent program. We'll have excellent teachers and staffs, and we'll do everything that we can do to accommodate each and every one of the children in our schools. Thank you. Okay, anyone else? Mr. Warner, do you have some?
I just want to add, like you said, you know, change is tough. I was redistricted when I was in middle school. I went from all my family went to Trist back in, this is, I'm going back 40 years, so bear with me. And at the time, Trist and Chalmette Middle was a huge rival. So I had two brothers that were going to Trist, and I was going to Chalmette Middle. So imagine what that household was like back then. But it is difficult, and some of the concerns on the lines, and I know you live, you know, I think it was Mr. Miller and Jesse, you live close, I don't know if they're still here, but you live close to Lacoste. If you look at the growth potential of Parish and where a lot of growth is occurring, it's occurring right behind Lacoste. So you're close too, but they're even closer to Lacoste. It's right on the 20 Auburn Canal, right behind that. They're building houses like crazy back there. Mm-hmm. And, you know, like Ms. Dysart, but I'm excited for the students that live in my district that they're getting ready to go to a brand new state-of-the-art with the best equipment, the best certified teachers you can get. And so I'm excited for them that they're going to that school. I know it's a little bit further from, you know, Lacoste is closer, but they're going to be in a school where the teacher to pupil ratio is going to be more aligned where they need to be. So like Mr. Long, I'm kind of in favor of where the lines are drawn, and I know it's tough. I've been through it, but on the other side, you might meet families and friends at the new school and make relationships like I did that will last a lifetime. So, thank you.
Okay. Anyone else? Is there a motion on the floor? Or is there more consideration that wants to be taken, or is there a motion at this time? Mr. Long.
I'll make a motion that we approve the administration's proposal for the new school attendance zones for Araby, Chalmette, Lacoste, Merrill, and Davies.
Okay, there's a motion by Mr. Long. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Okay, second by Mr. Warner. Okay, any further discussion?
Well, one other comment.
Mr.
Just, and I'm making this motion with the understanding that Ms. Voce plans on addressing any individual concerns or extenuating circumstances that might arise from this. And I know you've done this many times before, Ms. Voce, and you've always been a person that's been fair and equitable and compassionate, and you've always done what's best for the students of St. Bernard. So thank you for that.
Dr. Kraft.
Yes. I noted Ms. Voce took a lot of notes on this, and those that fit within the extenuating circumstances, that she'll be able to fit that possibly in with this motion that you made. I think that's what you indicated, that
yes.
What was brought up tonight, there will be some concessions made, but it will have to come from the superintendent's office.
Anyone else? Ms. Voce, I took my notes also, and I know we spoke about at the committee meeting about the daycare centers, and you know, as you mentioned, before the storm, most of the daycares had their own vans or their mm-hmm. transportation, and after the storm, we provided the buses to go, you know, drop the students off after school there at the daycare. And you said that some of the administrators have spoken with the daycare centers. Can you give us some information as to the daycares and whether or not they're going to continue to service those students within those areas, or what their plans are, if you would, please.
I can't speak for the daycare centers. They're business owners. I do know that we work closely with the daycare centers through our pre-K program and the early childhood network. So we have monthly meetings with the owners of the daycare centers over not only, you know, feeding into our four-year-old program, but their students, which are infants and toddlers, and the funding mechanism that goes to them in some cases. So I do know that there is, like I said, there is a daycare center in La Coste that is even expanding into, or has a satellite in the Davies area as well, and is talking about opening up another satellite also in the La Coste district, which would be before and after school. There are at least five daycare centers in the Merrow, in the new proposed Merrow School District, that offers after school and before school care, and if they are within the district, the school district, then we bus those children to and from those particular daycares. So there are ample daycare facilities in the Merrow District. In the La Coste, it depends upon the numbers of students. It was sufficient for the current La Coste daycare. I'm not sure how it will be for the new. It depends on how many people avail themselves of those services. And again, we provide as a school system our own before and after daycare. We call it our extended day program at Arabee Elementary School that is open to anyone who lives in St. Bernard Parish who is employed and has those particular issues of getting their children to school, needing to get their children to school earlier in the morning or staying late in the afternoon. So I think there are ample facilities at that point. In the La Coste area, I cannot guarantee that at the moment. I do know that there is currently care available there, and the I know that that particular daycare has indicated that they intend to expand.
Okay. Thank you. And just a clarification on the Arabee Elementary campus, that is an open enrollment if parent at Arabee, yeah. That, and they have daycare before and after, but you can live anywhere
in the district
and still go there
for the before and after. Correct.
As long as you're employed.
As long as you're employed.
Okay. Thank you for reiterating that. Okay. Anyone else? Okay. Mr. England.
I just want to thank all the parents for coming out here tonight, you know, to voice their concerns. And I really have to say this. We are taking by to heart everything that y'all have said tonight. And thank y'all.
Am I allowed to ask a question? Or no?
I'll be happy to talk with you individually. Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Anyone else? Okay, just as Mr. England said, we thank each and every one of you for coming tonight and expressing your concerns. And, you know, it's a difficult decision for us also. And, you know, as Ms. Voce said, we will address any other concerns that come along after that, okay? So thank you, and y'all did a great job. And thank you for loving St. Bernard Parish Schools. Yes. Okay. Anyone else before we go for a vote? Okay. Roll call vote, please. Ms. Voce. There's one motion on the floor, correct?
Yes. Okay. Mrs. Acevedo.
Yeah.
Mr. Campbell.
Four.
Dr. Kraft.
Yes.
Mr. Gaines?
Yes.
Mr. England?
Four.
Mrs. Dysart?
Four.
Mrs. LeMoyne?
Four.
Mr. Long?
Four.
Mr. Warner?
Four.
Motion passes 9-0.
Thanks again, everyone, for coming tonight. We appreciate it. Okay. Next item on the agenda are community concerns. Ms. Benizak, has anyone signed up besides the item four? Okay, thank you. Next item are committee assignments, and in your folder We have been, I think I named them in the committee meeting, so we don't have to name them again. Did anyone have any changes? There being none, committee assignments or as named. Next item on the agenda, a motion to incorporate the minutes of the February 2017 general committee meeting into the minutes of the February 2017 regular monthly meeting. There was a motion by Mr. Warner. Is there a second? Second by Ms. Lemoyne. Any discussion? Please cast your vote. Cast your votes.
Dr. Kraft? Motion passes 9-0.
Thank you, Ms. Oche. Next item is a motion to approve the following minutes. The regular monthly meeting minutes from November 15th as published on February 17th, 2017. Motion by Dr. Kraft, seconded by Mr. Gaines. Any discussion? There being none, please cast your votes.
Motion passes 9-0.
Next item is a review of performance contracts. And this is for information?
Just information.
Any discussion? Again, we're very blessed to have so many wonderful, dedicated administrators and employees with us in our school system. Okay, next item is a review of personnel changes for February 2017. And we also have the appointment of the Miro Elementary School Principal, Ms. Voce.
Okay, in your packet for information, Mr. Granberry has provided the personnel changes since the last meeting that we've had. And the appointment of the Miro Elementary Principal. I just want to make a couple of comments. We had two extremely qualified candidates apply for this principalship. Mrs. Larson and I did the interviews, and I tell you, it was an extremely difficult decision. Both of these candidates are in our plans for leadership positions in our school district. They both did incredibly well. They have been, I guess, just really dedicated people and teachers and administrators in our school system, and we're fortunate to have both. It was a very, very difficult decision, but we are going to appoint Natalie Albers as the new principal of Miro Elementary School. Ms. Albers has been in our school system for 15 years. She's a veteran in our school system. She actually lives in the new Miro Elementary District, so she will be living in the district of the school which she is the principal. She is currently the assistant principal of Lacoste Elementary School. Over the 15 years in her career, she has been a teacher at Smith Elementary, Lacoste Elementary, and Andrew Jackson Elementary. And then we had named her as a master teacher at Smith Elementary, where she was trained in the TAP model, which is a model to develop leadership among our teachers and guide them in that way and increase student achievement. She did an excellent job at Smith Elementary School. And then we tapped her to be the assistant principal at Lacoste. She has been there since the school opened in 2012, so she has experience in opening a new school. So there will be well over 300 students from the old Lacoste going to the new Miro Elementary School. So the new Miro Elementary School will have over half its population comprised of students from Lacoste, who will be extremely familiar with Ms. Albers, and she has worked with them on a daily basis, so we're very happy. She's been president of the St. Bernard Reading Association. She had been named the BPW Model Young Woman Award. So I think she is an excellent choice, and we're very happy to have her as the new principal of Miro Elementary School.
Congratulations to Ms. Albers. We know that you will be an excellent principal, and we appreciate you're opening up a new school, being the principal at a brand new school, and we I've seen Ms. Albers in action also, and I have confidence that she's going to do an excellent job. Okay. And Ms. Foce, if I could ask also about the it not concerning the principal, but on the staff, most of the teachers will ask for a transfer, they have an opportunity to request a transfer, correct?
Right. What what we're doing is the now that the lines have been set, then we are staffing with the elementary principals in the next few days, which will tell us the number of first grade teachers we're going to need, second grade teachers, third grade teachers. I am going to meet with the faculties of the current four elementary schools. I'm going to meet with them tomorrow, one school Thursday, one school Monday when we get back from the holidays, and the second one on Thursday we get back from the holidays, at which point we're going to allow the teachers input, ask what their preferences are going to be in terms of transferring to the new school, looking at different grade level configurations. So the majority of the staff at the new school will come from these four elementary schools. So we're going through that process of determining the openings based on the new district lines, and then we are going to personally, or I'm going to personally talk with each one of the faculties and talk with them about their options and ask for their preferences and try to do all that prior to what we call transfer day, and then whatever openings that we have after that, then we will open it to the rest of the district, and of course a job fair to anyone who is certified to come in and teach with us. So we have a lot to do, mm-hmm. I think, between now and the end of the school year.
Thank you, Ms. Foce, for explaining that process. Okay. Next item is a motion to approve the administration's request to advertise for proposals for ELA and math curriculum materials.
So moved.
There's a motion by Mr. Long, second by Mr. Gaines. Any discussion? There being none, please cast your votes.
Motion passes 9-0.
Thank you. Next item is a motion to approve the administration's request for permission to advertise for bids small food service equipment class 13 for the period of July 1st through 2017 through June 30th, 2018. Okay, there's a motion by Ms. Lemoyne. Is there a second? Second by Mr. Campbell. Any discussion? Please cast your votes.
Motion passes 9-0.
Thank you. Next item is, or items to be placed on the agenda of the next committee meeting.
I got one.
Mr. Warner.
Can we get an update, Ms. Voce, on what's going on with the letter grades and testing? I've been seeing a lot of stuff in the Advocate, and can we kind of get us up to speed on what's going on with testing and with the upheaval is up in Baton Rouge on that, and
on the new ESSA plan and what the proposed changes will be. Is
absolutely
what you're talking about.
Okay. I can get some clarity on that, because it's kind of confusing what I'm reading. Appreciate it. Thanks.
Sure. Anyone else? Dr. Craig?
Okay.
Okay, anyone else? Okay, next are superintendent's recommendations.
Okay, the just that we're winding down before the Mardi Gras break. I think on Friday all of our elementary schools will be having their Mardi Gras celebrations. That'll be a wonderful time. We'll see a lot of the kids on the streets with their pulling their wagons and floats, and parents and grandparents and relatives involved in those. Those are always a good thing. So many of our middle and high school, especially the high school, will be marching in many of the parades. So we, as we said in the opening prayer, we wish everyone well, even those who will be traveling out of town, to come back to us safely after that Mardi Gras break. I think Mr. Fernandez informed me that the brackets for the basketball playoffs have been set, and I think we're in the first round on Friday playing Southwood, who's going to be coming down from North Louisiana on our home court Friday night. So if anyone is interested in seeing the basketball playoff game, the first round, that will be Friday night at Shelmet High School at 7 o'clock, probably be a packed house. So if you're interested, you better come early. And I'll get a ticket ahead of time, I would think. And with that, I hope everyone has a very safe and happy holiday season.
Okay. Congratulations to Shelmet High School, and go Owls. And happy Mardi Gras to everyone. Stay safe. Okay, is there a motion to adjourn? There's a motion by Dr. Kraft, seconded by Mr. England. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
The meeting's now adjourned. Thank you, and good night.